Hello, everyone. I'm starting with a collection of old CDs. You might think CDs are only good for storing data, but I'll show you how to give them a completely new purpose, capable of some truly surprising feats. Next, I'm taking this silver duct tape. I'll cut a few strips from the roll. I need to carefully peel off the backing, exposing the sticky side. Then I'll meticulously apply the tape to one side of the CD, pressing it down firmly and wrapping it smoothly around the edge. This layer of metallic tape will act as a reflective surface, crucial for capturing signals. I'll repeat the process with another piece of silver tape to cover the remaining half of the CD. I want to make sure there are no air bubbles or wrinkles, so I'm pressing it down very smoothly. A neat, reflective surface is key for optimal performance as an antenna. Leave a comment and let me know which country you are watching from. It's great that we can connect and chat from all over the world. For the signal collection, I'm using three small razor blades. I'll arrange them equidistant around the center of the CD. To ensure precise placement, I'm marking their positions with a pen. These marks will guide me in drilling holes for mounting the blades securely. With the positions marked, I'll place the CD on a wooden block to provide a stable surface and prevent damage. Then, I'll use a drill to carefully make holes through the CD at each of the marked points. Accuracy here is important to ensure the blades are evenly spaced. Now, it's time to attach the razor blades. I'll use small screws and nuts to secure each blade through the drilled holes. It's important to tighten them well, but not so much that you crack the CD. The blades need to be firmly in place to maintain their orientation for effective signal reception. I'm repeating the process for the remaining two razor blades, ensuring they are all equally spaced and firmly attached. If you find this video interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any interesting ideas coming soon. This triangular arrangement is important for even signal distribution. To ensure proper connectivity, I'm using a thin wire. I'll secure it around one of the screws holding the razor blade. I'll repeat this for a second screw to create a robust electrical connection. Using pliers, I'll gently tighten the wire and trim any excess, ensuring a clean and effective contact for our signal path. Next, I'm working with a standard Wi-Fi router. I need to carefully open its casing by unscrewing the bottom panel. This is where we'll integrate our CD antenna with the router's existing system. Inside, you'll see the main circuit board. I'm going to identify specific points on this board where we can tap into its internal wiring for our antenna. I'm taking a blue wire, stripping a small portion of its insulation, and carefully soldering it to a designated point on the router circuit board. This establishes a critical connection for signal transmission. I'm doing the same with a red wire, stripping it and soldering it to another specific point on the circuit board. These connections need to be solid for reliable performance. With the wires soldered, I'll carefully reassemble the router casing, making sure all wires are tucked away neatly. I'm stripping the ends of the red and blue wires and twisting them together. Then, I'm attaching them to a standard electrical plug. This will provide power to our modified router setup. Using a screwdriver, I'm securing the red and blue wires firmly within the plug. A good connection here is crucial for safety and proper functioning. After securing the wires to the plug pins, I closed the plug and tightened it. Next, I'm taking a yellow Ethernet cable. I'll carefully strip back the outer jacket to expose the internal wires. I'll carefully twist these wires before connecting them to the antenna. I'm connecting stripped Ethernet wires to the razor blade mounting screws on our CD. These connections are twisted tightly to ensure good signal transfer from the antenna. Using pliers, I'm crimping the twisted wire connections to secure them even further. This step guarantees a stable and effective connection, preventing any signal loss or disconnections. This Ethernet cable will then plug directly into one of the router's ports, sending the enhanced signal through the router and potentially to your TV. It's all about creating a seamless signal path. I'm placing our finished CD antenna assembly right on top of the router and securing it with hot glue. This ensures it stays firmly in place, ready to capture signals. Before plugging in our new creation, you can see the TV clearly shows no signal. This is our baseline, showing the poor reception without any external help. I'll even try to change channels with the remote, but as expected, nothing happens. It's frustrating when you can't watch your favorite shows, right? I'll connect the power plug of our DIY router antenna setup. Watch closely as the TV instantly comes to life with a clear, vibrant picture. I can now effortlessly switch between channels, and each one loads perfectly with excellent quality. This is the magic of our repurposed CD antenna working its wonders. I can even surf through different channels using the remote, just like a regular smart TV. This homemade device provides excellent reception and a wide array of viewing options. Our TV signal is strong and stable, all thanks to this simple, creative DIY project. Our incredible, multifunctional smart TV setup made from simple recycled materials. To prove the effectiveness, I'm unplugging the coaxial cable from the TV, demonstrating that the standard antenna input is not in use. And plugging it back in doesn't change anything. The signal is still coming through our DIY setup. This incredible transformation from old CDs and a router truly showcases the power of creativity and repurposing. This DIY device proves that with a little creativity, you can achieve amazing things and save money. If you enjoyed this project and found it inspiring, please give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and leave a comment below telling me what other unexpected tools or smart devices you'd like to see me create. Don't forget to subscribe for more fantastic DIY ideas. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.